Excuse me, Commander?
What is it, Cotton?
Where were you between the hours of 8 p.m. and midnight on the night of last night?
What? Why?
Well, a new monster appeared and,
Oh, and I wasn't around to give the commands?
No, sir, have you eaten anything strange recently?
What's going on?
We think it's you, sir. We think you're a were-Barioth.
A what?
A were-Barioth. A Warioth.
But
it looks exactly like you. Exactly like you.
You piece of... Ladies, gentlemen, and monsters of all ages, there are a few more wondrous times in the Monster Hunter world, Iceborne, than the arrival of a new beastie to lay our weapons upon, a new creature to slay, a monster to full-on hunt. And today we have a special one, a nice addition, something a little unusual, especially in the new world, a post-release DLC monster that is... mid-tier. I know we've had Rajang and Devil Joe, who are not Elder Dragons, but those are generally considered a good step above Barioth, so with Barioth being given a variant of his very own, I have to ask, does it pack as much of a challenge as the other two? Well, the challenge varies by weapon, but if you are looking for any sort of help or information, or even the tiny little tidbits that may never come up in a hunt, but will make you stop and go, huh, how about that? Then maybe, just maybe, just maybe I can help you out with that. I can. Please don't leave me. Starting off with the most general of things before getting into his specific new moves, this version of Barioth, this Frostfang furry boy, does not have tornadoes. That's right. Any of you who are tired of cylindrical cyclones of wind can consider yourselves free, as they are no more. Instead, they've been replaced by cold goop. That's right, instead of his icy tornadoes, Frostfang Barioth learned that one singular Velcana move and decided that should be an entire moveset. So, get ready to be slowed thoroughly. Though there is a couple of specific ways to make it far less lethal than it would otherwise be. See, Frostfang seems to be written in a way where if you are trapped in his glowing cold goop, he is very, very likely to do his pounce attack on you and just instantly murder you. You just die. This stuff is meant to be an avoid at all costs type of thing, and getting out of it after it catches you is supposed to feel almost lucky. But there are two ways that you can, as the player, influence this. The first is Iceproof Mantle. I want to be very clear here, because it's unusual as all hell, but Polar Mobility, the skill, does not work. It does nothing. Iceproof Mantle, however, does work, but not quite how you may hope. If you walk into an ice patch with Iceproof Mantle on, you have a short animation, but then you can walk around freely. The difference being that normally you have to slowly walk around the entire time until you actually exit the ice patch. So Iceproof still has a moment of no mobility, but it makes it better in general and could definitely save you if you're struggling with this. The second option is actually Torch Pods. Torch Pods get rid of these patches of ice faster when shot at them. And while this will have limited use in solo hunts, I could totally see this saving someone's life in multiplayer, so keep that in the back of your head for the future. Another thing that may enter the back of your head in the future is his beam, specifically in this case, when you flinch him. He will respond by firing a bunch of ice at you, because he can. So if you flinch him, just watch out for this little jump here. But if you want to slow down not only these beams, but just the power of his ice beams in general as a whole, then all you have to do is break his fangs. His Frost Fangs.
He said it!
It weakens his elemental powers as a whole, and seeing as his weakest point to cutting, blunt, and ranged damage is his head, it makes it quite easy to focus on as a group. Finally, for more the general notice information then, he is on the Hoarfrost Reach, of course, where he starts in his nest in the cave of Zone 7, then his next zone is Area 7 proper, then into Area 6, down into Area 11 in the cave, where he goes back up to Area 7 and continues on through the pattern. As for specific attacks, this is where he gets particularly spicy. And by spicy, I mean hot. And by hot, I mean attractive. And by attractive, I mean pleasing. And by pleasing, I mean I enjoy fighting him. I'll stop doing this, I'm sorry. Most importantly and most fight-affectingly, you know all those telegraphs he has that I'm always raving about whenever I talk about regular Barioth? Talking about how I love his animations and how they always give you tons of warning on what he's about to do if you know them? Well, that both has and hasn't changed. Frostfang's telegraphs are almost identical to regular Barioth because he shares a lot of the same moveset, except for two ish. One, this telegraph. Previously, this was what led to his super speed pounce attack, which was his most dangerous move. Now, this has one of four different results. A lengthy forward beam that leaves a patch of slowing ice under it, a small horizontal spray in an arc that leaves a line of slowing ice in front of him, or my personal favorite, a personal tracking face slam on the floor. And then the final thing that he can do out of this telegraph is a massive long distance ice ball super explosion. This thing is so deadly. Ranged users, beware. It's worth mentioning that each of these, except for the head slam, can be done twice in a row while he is enraged. My personal tip for avoiding these attacks is to be aware of the patterns. The only one of these attacks that hits directly in front of him is the head slam. So if you dodge diagonally forward because the head slam has limited horizontal reach, you avoid the potential head slam, but then also any and all shapes of beam, as he just doesn't beam like that. So if you see this telegraph, you can safely give him a little forward diagonal roll and you'll be just fine, no matter what the attack actually winds up being. Two, the actual big paw slam itself. Its telegraph is now way bigger and more intense, but for very reasonable reasons. The telegraph starts now with him spraying out some ice in front of him, then doing a backflip to create space, only to land and pounce immediately right on top of you with his big attack, but augmented with a sizable ice explosion that comes along with it. This explosion also does damage to you, and like the other attacks mentioned so far, when enraged, he can do it twice in a row if he wants to, though the second time it won't have ice. I love that little detail though, because the ice part of the attack is shown through his preparation within the telegraph. He makes the ice exist before he can use it. So of course there isn't just more there because he wants to jump again. This kind of detail, it just makes him feel so much more alive, you know, for a savage wizard Barioth.
Wait, what did you call him?
As for other moves, Frostfang has replaced the aerial tornado attack with an aerial ice circle. He just fires out a ball on the floor, and a circle of the slowing goop appears around it. It's easy to avoid once you know what he's doing. As for more general tips, ice resistance is unsurprisingly quite nice in this fight. As well, his weakness charts line up with regular Barioth, which means that fire is the best element to bring, and the head is his main weak point, with the claws being especially weak to element in particular. One final note is that Bonborough is not only on the map, but is totally willing to have a turf war and break a chunk of health off of Frostfang himself if he happens to wander over. So maybe try and force that to happen if you want the extra damage. And that just about covers everything that you need to know about the fight itself. So let's take a nice proper quick look over to the weapons and armor. Now if you want a more in-depth breakdown of these, we already have a video going fully into each of these separately, but for conciseness sake, the weapons are pretty damn decent. Not quite better than Kiara weapons for ice, but great raw for an ice element focused weapon. And things like Gunlance and Light Bowgun could have new niche builds from them. The equipment has great stats though, as far as the armor goes, but is highlighted by the set bonus of one piece Punishing Draw and three piece Slugger's Secret. Capcom is listening to me. They put my favorite skills together. What a day!
Loud and clear, Capcom.
And if you haven't been able to tell by now by how I've talked about it so far, I absolutely love this fight. I think they did a great job. Not only did they take Barioth, a monster that I personally enjoy, but I know lots of people have issues with, and make him more manageable. I mean, think about how much less he zooms around the place now. Like, he may not be literally easier, but he's definitely more friendly to melee users, easy to stick with. But then also on top of that, they made an interesting and fun fight based around sticky ice, a patch on the ground that essentially removes all of your mobility. And yet I enjoyed the fight as someone who despises mechanics in this game that take away your movement control. Maybe it's the fact that it always comes from the same place, the same attacks, and you can learn to work around it. But I actually enjoy this. I enjoy this fight, and this mechanic only adds to it. It may not be the hardest creature that we've ever had added to the game, but that isn't a bad thing. Not everything has to be hard, especially when it is this fun. Well, that's my opinion anyways. Alright everyone, I've been Cotton Dinosaur, and this has been everything that you need to know about Frostfang Barioth, from A to Brr. Do you like this monster as much as I do? How excited are you for all those Punishing Draw builds in the meta now? Or the return of Slugger's Secret Hammer? Like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more, and most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, until next time, stay sweet.
This is the brand new outro to tell you all the things that you do that we love. So let's start with something simple and say, oh, we love your eyes. When they're watching us play video games, when we make a bunch of jokes that are kinda lame, or when they gaze upon our failures as we try to kill the monsters or report important news about the Kingdom Animalia. Rage, Cotton, and Hollow are all here talking about the things you want to hear. So if you want to be the first to hear, like and subscribe and the bell and we'll cheer. Some of you are patrons even though we are all the noobs and you're the pros. There's nothing we can do to thank you.
No, really, there's nothing we could possibly do. Goodbye.